Hello.
Hello and welcome. Today I'll be showing you guys 10 ways you can build a 4x4 room in your V-Rising castle. This video is the second in a series of tutorials I will be putting out regarding castle building. If you haven't seen my first video on stair layouts, I'll link it here and in the description below. Alright now, let's get started. So for this first example, example number one, we're going to do kind of something similar we did last time with our little example showcases. And I've kind of showed up all the squares for the 10 examples on this single plot. And this kind of gives you an idea of the size of these plots too, which is kind of interesting. Anyway, that's not relevant to what we're doing today. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start off with our first example. Our first example, we're going to make a cozy fireplace with a sofa. So let's just make sure we have a nice closed room here. We're just gonna build it up. And you know, maybe we have a door right there so we can exit. And yeah, so this is the beginning or the start of this room. We're gonna add a fireplace. So maybe we'll have, well, we can go with any kind of fireplace really, but I mean, we could go with the big fancy one, we could go with the middle one, and we can go with the small one. I think I'm going to go with the middle one for this example. I really like this particular fireplace. And you can already hear everything crackling, which is nice. Then we can choose whatever kind of couch we want to use. I could use something like this, or I could use something like this. I mean, we have only like 4 real options for this kind of thing, but they're all really nice. And of course, I wouldn't put this bench in front. This looks more like an outdoor bench to me, or like an outside or hallway bench. But yeah, that'll be a tutorial for another day. So I'm gonna start off by putting this sofa here. This sofa is going to be, I'm gonna make sure it's aligned first, right? So with the sofa aligned, I'm going to push it back 1, 2, 3, 4 spaces, and it's about halfway through the room. Now the reason why I off-center it away from the fireplace is because, well, obviously you want space to be in front of it, and a lot of times I like to put a carpet underneath, so we're gonna do just that. We're gonna go into decorations, carpets. And we have a few different options. We can go with something like this. We could go with a round circle rug kind of thing. There's also the smaller options. Well, actually, this one isn't as small, but this one is really small. So we could choose like a really small option like this. Another option could be maybe using like a square carpet, like one of these. I think a square carpet here does look really nice in this room. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to take it and move it forward by 1 to be just at the edge of the fireplace here. And yeah, so far so good. I could push the couch forward 1 just to align it with the carpet a little bit better. That is an option, but I personally think it's too close to the fireplace, so I'm just going to push it back by 1. Alright, so now that that's done, we can also keep in mind, you can also do fireplace situation like this as well. I don't like to do that, but that is a possibility. Now we need to figure out what this room needs to look like, and the foundation is probably the first thing we can work on. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to leave this foundation. The foundation I'm using here is called, it's under library flooring, and it's called elocution parquet. Wow, that's such a complicated name for that. But yeah, it's the third one, and you basically can place these squares. I could also use a richer kind of wood if I wanted to, just to warm up the room a little tiny bit. Or I could even use one of these just to maybe have something a little bit more visually interesting on the ground. I think for this example though, we're gonna go with the either light colored flooring or this one. I think the flooring I use is going to change depending on what I end up doing with the rest of the space. So let's work on the wallpapers. Now for the wallpapers, I like to use like a wooden wall sometimes just to kind of keep a nice warm feel to the room. You could also use something like this to keep it nice and fancy. We're gonna go with this actually today. We're gonna go with this red background wallpaper. for today's example, but I think that... So we're going to start off by putting some clocks or some kind of furniture in here. So maybe we'll have a clock maybe near the back of the room or something, maybe like right here. Trying to figure out what kind of clock I want to use. My personal favorite is the first choice, but I think that the cordial long case clock can also fit this purpose really, really well. Here we go. We have like a side table, which I could put the side table like over here, or I could put it like in the corner or something. So maybe we'll put this side table here in the corner. And we can also put down some bookcases or some books. So we could do something like that. I could also add something like this little luminescent mushroom terrarium, which I really, really like this thing. It's so cool. So I'm just going to place that here. I think I'm going to put it closer toward the corners. We could also put something like a dignity folding screen behind the chair to create like a little bit more privacy, so that if anyone's like in the room and they're just kind of like peeping in, they don't have to like, you know what you're doing. And also it creates a more cozy feel because the room space is being closed up. You can also let's add some storage. We're gonna add a bookcase then. We could use a big bookcase, which unfortunately does not fit here, so we're gonna have to use small ones. I think I probably can only get one small one to fit there, but I can get another one to fit here if I really wanted to. Or I can just turn them both this way. I mean, it's definitely something to think about. I can fit three here if I decide to use the thin long cases. Sorry, the thin bookcases I meant, not long cases. I don't know why I said that. Another option could be to put down something like some vases. So I'm gonna add a vase here. Let's go with something a little simpler, maybe something like this. I like to use vases that have like a square bottom, because if I decide to put plants in there later, it definitely is a possibility to hide it. And I'll show you guys what I mean by that in a little bit. But there's a glitching flowers trick that I like to use that it has been very, very nice. Well, we can actually have like candle holders too. So if we want to have like a candle holder, we can choose one of these. Something like this is pretty nice. We could maybe take, let me see, if I put this here, we can use like a red one, or if you want to use a white one, you can. The white ones look pretty good in the room. Or you can use the natural colored light, which is always a solid option if you're not sure what color to go with. You could also use something a little bit fancier, like these verdant candle sconces. I like to use the ardent candle sconce too sometimes, or the ancient symphony candelabra. Oh my god, I hope I said that right. but yeah, we're gonna place this here. This one is also pretty good. I think we're gonna settle on this design. We're gonna go with this, the ancient symphony one, just for this particular build. So yeah, we're gonna go with that. Maybe I want to add something like, I don't know, maybe I want some flying lights in here. I could add some modest flying lights like above where the books are, maybe to add a little bit of extra light in there, so I can read what is on the books. So, you know, you could add something like that. You could also maybe have a chandelier or something if you really wanted to. There's a lot and a lot of options. I actually really like the idea of just putting a white light here just to kind of create a little bit more clarity with what's going on. You don't have to use the same colored lights everywhere in the same room, so that's just something to think about. But yeah, this is a very simple, like, basic example. For this, well, actually, I'm going to show you guys what I mean by why I use these flower bases, right? Okay, so it looks like the carpet's actually going to prevent me from showing the example. So maybe this wasn't the best idea, but I'll still show you anyway. I'll show you. So for this vase, if I put the planter underneath this vase and I place, like, I don't know, maybe I give myself Let's go with some blood rose seeds. And I'm going to place one right over here. And this actually glitches itself up onto the planters. So I'm going to make time pass so that we can see what it looks like when it's done. This is what it would look like when it's done. So yeah, this is a really nice trick that you can use. This is something that I use on pretty much every build I make. I really like it a lot. I think the blood roses look nice there. I just keep in mind, you can't do it in areas where you place carpet. So let's say I wanted to remove these vases and put something else here. I definitely could. So one example might be something like a table. Like I could put like a side table. So let's put, I didn't even do the walls now I think about it, but let's put some stuff on the walls first. So maybe we'll put like this one and that one, and you know, we could put like maybe a square one or rectangular one over here, and they could all have different things. I could also, instead of putting that, put something like a wall ornament, like a drapery that I could put here, which could also serve that purpose. So yeah, this is something to think about. The room doesn't have to be perfectly symmetrical when you decorate it. In fact, I would encourage you to do pretty much anything you want to do as far as like your looks. I mean, everything is subjective. So yeah, this is definitely a good option. Something I have done as well is put the storage. So like I like to take the bureaus, for example, or the secretaires, and you can put them right behind the couch, so you can have like a little storage area here, you know. So if you don't like the bookcases, or you don't want to have bookcases here, you don't want to have this kind of thing, and you just want a storage container, you can just hide it right here behind there. So that's another option. Very, very good option in my opinion. And of course you can add like all types of stuff. So yeah, this is just one example of many that are to come in this video. So I hope that this one might suit your fancy for some of you out there. So next we're gonna go to example two. Example two, we're going to do something a little bit different. So for this example, we're going to make an outdoor water fountain and sitting area. So let's do that. We're going to start off with the garden stuff. We're gonna go with, maybe we'll do like a fence. Maybe, you know what, let's go with the nocturne garden fence. You can use any fence, or, well, any fence will do, but I do think that this could potentially be a really nice setup for someone. So yeah, I just happen to be putting the doors on the left, but you can put the doors pretty much anywhere. I think that goes without saying, but I feel like saying that might be a good idea. Yeah, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna maybe go with some let's go with like a water fountain. So we're gonna start off with maybe something a little smaller than this. We could go with something like this, maybe get it perfectly in the center. Let's see, I believe this is perfect in the center. Okay, yeah, this looks to be perfectly aligned. So we have a nice water fountain in the center. It would probably help if I had the right kind of foundation down. So for the purpose of this video, I'm just gonna get a nice green grass foundation, because for some reason there's no snow tiles, which now that I think about it is kind of silly. I hope that they add like snow tiles in the end, but that's, you know, a story for another day, I guess. We could also have something like, let's see, if we, I mean, we could add a path. So we could go with a nice garden path. We can go with something, maybe something a little bit more solid. We could go with something like this, where maybe we have a nice setup here. Gonna add our corners, and we can maybe add a nice sitting area out here. So we can add Might be a bench. We can add a bench. Oh, actually, yeah. You know what? Let's add a couple of benches here. We can also add a rural garden table or something here that we can use as like a table to sit at. Actually, I'm just gonna use the white version of these. And tuck these chairs in. So that's another nice little sitting area situation we can have set up. We can maybe even have something like a, maybe instead of a table, we can go back to that chessboard we were looking at earlier. And we can actually add the chessboards in. So we can put them right over here and then add the chairs. So these chairs are sitting really, really close to the chess table. I think maybe like one extra thing back might not hurt, because when you sit in there, you don't want your knees going through the table necessarily. So just something to think about. Yeah, so I think this is a nice setup, but yeah, you could just move these in if you really want to. Another option could be something like maybe a careful placement of pillars. So let's say we want to add, let's say we add a pillar like, I don't know, maybe like right. I'm trying to think what's a good example. Maybe like right here. Let's say we add a pillar right there, right? Obviously, the chessboard is kind of clipping through it, but we can move it over a little bit. And then we can move the chairs in and around it if we want to. We can also add something like maybe a certain lighting here. So maybe we want to add something like a pillar-mounted light. You know, we can have outdoor candlelight. We can have... these things are modular, so you could add a few different things. You could also add maybe something like this, you know, a light above to make sure that the area is well lit. You could do the same on this side. I'm not going to do it for this example, but it's just something to think about. You can also put maybe some flowers here. So if you want to plant some flowers, you can. So you can go into production, growing plots, and then exterior growing plot. And then you can start placing all of your plants as much as you want to kind of fill in these spaces if you really want to. So yeah, these spaces look pretty nice. You can put in like maybe on the left and right side if you really want to. So we're gonna do that for this example. You could also add maybe some flowers on the outside here just to create a little bit of visual variety, as I like to say.
I cannot build here.
But yeah, I think that this is probably a really nice setup so far. We can place maybe some let's use a different flower for this example. So maybe some let's go with a snowflower seed. And let's plant.
This will not work.
All right, and we're gonna get this side. Something else you can add out here would be something like garden planters. So you can also add hedges and things like that. I don't like to add too many hedges in my gardens. I think they eat up a lot of space that you could use for like three or four items. So for me, it's just not my personal preference, but something else to mention is you can also add castle wall vegetation. So that's something I forgot to mention. So you can add some wall vegetation here. Now you have a lot more of an interesting setup. You could also add, like I said, the garden planters. So maybe we can go with something like this on a corner. So maybe I'll add this right here. And we'll add something like, I don't know, we could add a bush or something that looks good. Maybe something like this.
I cannot build here.
There we go. So we're gonna add that in. Let me make sure it matches the rest of the colors. We also have another option where we could place, like, I don't know, maybe something like a trellis part here. So we could go with maybe this one. And, or actually, what you can do, or something I like to do, is use the smaller ones. So if you use the smaller ones, you can place two of them and it won't look as crazy. but yeah, that's also a very valid option here. This actually eats up this area really well because it doesn't kill the thematic, but it also kind of creates a little bit of a visual interest. And something you can do with these, which is something really cool that I like to do, is you can place things in the bottom of these as well. So what I usually do is I add some exterior growing plots underneath this. Can't see them yet, but when they grow, you will. And then we can plant those there. So let's speed up time real quick and see what it looks like. So now we have a beautiful little outdoor garden area with a calm, relaxing water. And you have a nice setup here. And notice you have some snowflowers growing out of these. So yeah, you can add a bunch of different things here. You know, maybe I could have put the planters here and there. You could also move around, stuff like this. But yeah, this is just one example of like maybe a nice outdoor area that can be built with 4x4. All right, so for our next example, I'm actually going to go all the way over here to example number three. For example number three, we have an outdoor picnic area. So this is going to be a lot like the other one, but it's going to be different in the sense that the picnic area is going to use different furniture. So I figured it'd probably be important for me to show this just because you don't really see that a lot in castles, and I think that a lot of people would actually really like this kind of thing. So I'm just going to demonstrate here. Anyway, we're going to place picnic tables. So we're going to go to decoration, furniture, larger tables, and then we're going to go with the rustic table. Now, the rustic table is nice because you can place them kind of like long ways if you really want to. And they also don't take up a ton of space. So let's say I want to have, I don't know, maybe another picnic table here. Or, you know, maybe I only want to have these three squares. Maybe I don't want to have four squares worth of picnic tables. I can do that. But yeah, I'm just going to use these three as an example. And then we're going to have like an exit out. So, and what we're going to do is we're going to mismatch the tables with, instead of using indoor tables like these, sorry, not tables, indoor chairs like these, we're going to use the garden chairs since we're outdoors. So we're going to put down some garden furniture here. We're going to go with this brown rural garden chair, and we're gonna have one and two and another one and two. Yeah, so now we have these beautiful little garden tables, a little outdoor thing you can do. If you want, you can, instead of having grass, you could have something like maybe an outdoor cobblestone. So let's go with like a cobblestone this time, just to kind of show the example. All right, so now we've changed the ground to cobblestone, and we have these little rustic tables. So yeah, this is a really, really nice setup. Now, you're probably wondering, you know, this looks kind of plain. What can we do, right? So we're going to do the trick again with the castle pillars, and we're going to use castle pillars to make up for the lack of lighting. For this square, we're going to go with some lighting like this. Maybe if you want, if you're feeling a little bit more daring, you could go with something like a baleful hanging lantern, which I like these for outdoors because open flames outdoors always look really, really cool. So yeah, I like to use these here. You can also maybe do something like you could have like some flying lights. Like you could add like a maybe an outdoor like chandelier in the center or something, or you could have chandeliers above each table, which is another option I've done stuff with in the past. You can also Let's go with that. I actually really like how that turned out. So let's go with these. And instead, now that we don't need these lights, these lamps, I mean, what we're going to do is we're going to change them out for something else. So we're going to use a different pillar ornament decoration. We could use maybe some flags here. I'm thinking maybe something like these. You know, just to add a little bit of extra three-dimensional feel to the space, which is also pretty cool. You don't have to have them all four. You could probably use something else. Like, if you wanted to, you can maybe use something like a thing like this. Maybe if you want to keep the ones that are north and south to be flat instead. And then just have the side ones sticking out, which is also a really good option. So, yeah, the outdoor picnic area, definitely something to consider when doing your outdoor spaces. You can also, one last thing I want to add to this particular space is you can also add maybe something like a, let's see, we have a bird bath, for example. So we could add a bird bath over here just to kind of add a little bit more, not just coziness in a way, but just like something to kind of keep the brain going so you're not bored while you're waiting for your food. So that's something to think about. And again, you can also put another water fountain right here just to kind of keep, you know, just kind of keep the sounds of the area to kind of keep it nice and calm and chill. And, you know, it's super relaxing to listen to when you're sitting out here. So yeah, you can just imagine just sitting here, maybe you invite your friends over and you can chill. So yeah, this is another great example, I think, for like an outdoor sitting set. So we're gonna move on to the next example. Next example is an outdoor garden area. Now you're probably wondering, what is the difference between the fountain with the sitting area and the garden area? Well, the garden area is going to focus primarily on plants. So for this particular build, we're going to go with a garden fencing. We're gonna use maybe the rural garden fencing. I really like this one a lot. I'm gonna go with the nice rustic feel here. Or rural, I guess you could say. And we're gonna switch out the foundation to be something like, maybe something a little bit more, relaxed. Okay, so we have some options, right? Let's say we have an outdoor flooring. So instead of cobblestone, we can use something like maybe the mossy cobblestones or the rough floor. I'm gonna go with a rough floor this time for this example. And we're also going to add something in the center here. We need some kind of centerpiece. So to facilitate that, we're gonna make a growing plot. We're gonna place the growing plot right in the center. So I'm just gonna quickly eyeball it, make sure that it is indeed in the center, which it is not. Okay, looks like we're good, we're aligned. I'm gonna give myself an acorn. And we're gonna plant that acorn. And I'm still gonna use maybe something like some growing plots here. We could use something like this if we want to create nice little planted areas. We could also use something like this, which, I mean, they only hold one plant though, so it's kind of, I don't want to use the word useless, but like, it doesn't really do much unless you're putting them in some kind of formation, I think. All right, so because we placed down the cobblestones, we have to use small growing plots if we're going to place any seeds down that are not in a container. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to actually have different pots here. So maybe I can place a water fountain here, or you could go with like, actually, yeah, you can either go with like a water fountain, or if you don't wanna use a water fountain, you can use something like a water well. The water wells are really nice. I really like the way these look. I'm gonna actually remove the oak tree and I'm gonna move it over to the corner. I've decided I'm gonna change this up. So instead we're gonna have the nice little water thing in the center. Maybe that's not the best thing. I don't know. There we go. Oh, it's not quite right. There we go. So now we have that in the center. We could also maybe do something like adding a statue even. Like you can add, let's see, we have statues out here. Like maybe I want to add this statue, right? Like if I want to add this statue and let's say I place it maybe like right here, that could be cool. And then I could place maybe a couple of these growing plots here and there. Well, I could also replace one of these tiles with grass if I really wanted to. And that would open up possibilities because then at that point I can place any of these, which I really like. I usually place them one by one, but for this example, I'm not gonna do that. And the nice thing is you can actually place these underneath things like the water fountain. You can place it underneath wells, water fountains, and tombstones. You can also place them under tombstones, so that's something else to consider. Let's place this tree up here.
This will not work.
Did I already place a thing here? Oh no, hold on a second, am I not able to plant?
I cannot build here.
It's too close to the fence. Okay. There we go. So now we have our tree set up. Okay, so something else I'm gonna add here is maybe some more snow flowers. We are in the Hollowed Mountains after all, so we don't want to miss out on that. So I'm just gonna use these flowers here.
This will not work.
Maybe I went too far in with this. Let me check. I think I might have done too many. There we go. Remember, you don't have to plant in every single spot, especially when you're getting close to stuff like this. Another option we can do is we can take the, we can put out maybe another outdoor bench, or actually an indoor bench we can use outdoors. It would be something like this, which you can place maybe like right here if you want to create a nice little sitting area. There's a lot of things you can do with these spaces. Let's just fast forward time so that you guys can see the final result. So now we have the final result. This is what it ends up looking like. Oh, and I completely forgot to place any plants in here, but yeah, you could definitely plant things like if I wanted to put like maybe two blood rose seeds in here. I guess we have to speed up time again to see that. So now, this is what the final result would look like. You have a nice tree here. You have, you know, maybe a statue. You have some flowers. You have some options here. And this could be a nice little cozy area. Like, imagine if, like, this tree was, like, back here instead. You know, overhanging the bench. Like, that kind of stuff would definitely help, create a nice looking front yard if you want to do something like that. So, yeah, we're done with this example. Let's move on to example number 5. So, example number 5 is actually going to be another indoor build. And it's going to be a closet. So, you know, maybe we want to give our vampire a place to store their clothes. Maybe we want them to have a place to maybe not store their clothes, but also just kind of look nice. You know, maybe look into their wardrobe and kind of choose something nice. Maybe we can go with something like a carpet. Maybe we can go with like a nice carpet. For the flooring, we can use the Taylor flooring for that. Maybe we can use a... we're gonna go to production, dominance, and then mirrors. And we're gonna add a mirror here to this build. So maybe we wanna go with something, we could go like something like this, actually. By the way, this mirror, I believe, is from the Halloween set. So yeah, the Haunted Knight standing mirror. So most of the new players probably won't have this, but around Halloween time, they usually give out like a free DLC bundle for everyone to download. So yeah, that's part of this set. And yeah, another thing we could do is add maybe some storage. So we could put some tailoring storage. So if we want to have the option to maybe make our own clothing, maybe something a little bit more sophisticated, I don't know, we could do that. Or maybe we keep things like, you know, our jewels in here. You can keep like a nice little jewel storage area. The bad thing about the jewel storage is because it's considered a storage, you can't actually place a chair like right in front of it, which in my opinion kind of sucks because it kind of kills the idea of like, you know, being able to sit there. So like, for example, like if I try to place it here, it just says blocked by jewel storage. So that's very unfortunate. But what we can do is we can keep that there anyway, and even though we can't place a chair there, we can maybe place a chair on the other side here, just on the side, that maybe kind of alludes to the idea, I don't know. We could also add something like a well, we could add some vases if we want to, but since this is more of a quiet area of the castle where you probably won't be seeing many guests, that's probably not the best of ideas. So I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put up maybe a book storage here. Let's go with something like, I don't know, I mean, I don't know, maybe you wouldn't want books in your storage now I think about it, but yeah, we could put all types of stuff here. So I'm gonna go with like these red curtains and just kind of fill up, you know, the size of the room. It's like I said, this isn't something that most people will be seeing. Maybe I'll change up the wallpaper just so you guys can see it a little bit better. Well, so I can see a little bit better, more like. There we go. And now we have a much fancier room already automatically. We could also place a rug here. This is something I like to do whenever I'm trying to, you know, make like a closet area, because I find that if I put a rug here, it kind of reinforces the idea of what the room is supposed to be. So we're gonna put that there, and we're gonna put a maybe like a circular rug here in the center. And let's go with maybe like a white rug. So yeah, we can have this here. You know, we can also have maybe some furniture items. So we can add stuff like, if we go to furniture, then miscellaneous, we can grab some cordial or dignity folding screens. I'm gonna grab the dignity ones just for this example. And you know, we're gonna have a folding screen basically right here, so that like if anyone comes into the room randomly, they're not going to randomly see you changing. I mean, I could also move this over here and stuff like that, but you know, I think this gives like the general idea of like how you could use these curtains. Something else you could do is you can add more curtains. Like maybe if you're really paranoid, you can put like one on the side here. You can connect them all together if you want, actually. And these actually have looks like mirrors right here, so you can you know, have like a full like all around closet area to look through, and you can escape through the sides here if you really wanted. But yeah, that is something that I really like about this, is that you have, you know, lots and lots of options. But yeah, you can just, well, actually that's too close. Let's push it back a little bit. There we go. Oh, it's not centered. Okay. There we go. So now we have a nice little hidden area, and this could be a nice little wardrobe. You could also put something like, actually something else that I thought was interesting is there's these new items where you can place, where are they? I'll find them. They're like these mannequin looking things, but they're not mannequins. This is, well, they are mannequins. They're like training dummies. That's what it is. You can place some mannequins down. So let's say you want to place, like, I don't know, this little assassin mannequin. You could do that right here. Whoops, I'm too close. The problem with these target dummies, using them as any kind of indoor storage especially, is that they eat up a lot of space around them. Like, for some reason, their hitbox is like huge. And I think it's because they're actual striking dummies. Like, these are actual real striking dummies. So yeah, that's just something to keep in mind as far as the kinds of things you can do in rooms like this. But yeah, this would be a nice little closet setup. Oh, one last thing I meant to add is you also want to add some lighting in here. I don't know why I completely forgot about adding lighting in here, but all right, let's go with this. Yeah, so this chandelier here right above your head, it lights up the space. It looks good. And if you need more lighting than that, of course, you can add something on the pillars, like maybe a pillar mounted light, maybe something like this. And you can put like maybe a couple of them on the side here. There you go. So now you have a nice well-lit little room. All right, so for example number 6, we're going to do something a little bit different. We're going to make a servant's quarters. So what we're going to do is we're going to put the walls up first. Whoops, that was a mistake. And let's put that door here and maybe close set up there. And maybe we want to add some servants. So we could put servant coffin here. You could put a couple of them side by side. Maybe you want to add two more side by side here. You could also add a little mirror here for the servants so that you can make sure that their appearance is at least appropriate for work. let's see, we also have some wallpaper, so maybe we go with something like this, or even something like that even. I don't know. But yeah, you have options. So let's say the servant quarters looks like this. And let's say our foundation, we want to use something maybe a little bit darker. We can use something like this. And now we have the servant coffins. Maybe they're all facing this way. Maybe they're not. But something I like to do is I like to create a little space here for them to use that mirror. Now, something that might be really good here would be to use like a carpet. So a rug or carpet placement right here might be pretty strategic, actually. So that's another option to consider. So if I wanted to put like a rug right here, I can, just to create a little bit of extra visual variety here. If I don't like this rug, I could go with something like this, where maybe I'm taking it from the doorway. I always measure my carpets from the doorways first. And then once it connects, you are pretty much set to go. And that's how I make sure that my carpets are aligned every single time. So yeah, we have a, like, maybe like a carpet going this way, you know, leading to the outdoors. Maybe we have some books. I've been using the same bookcase. Let's use a smaller bookcase, maybe something like this. Or actually, you know what, a better option, we could use something like this and then have something like a storage, like an armoire or something down here. So for the storage, we go to general storage, and you can use like certain kinds of containers. So maybe something like this. Actually, let me see if I can. Oh, I'm blocking it. yeah, we could use something like this or this, maybe, to kind of I don't know, create like maybe something a little bit different. You can also maybe even like remove this and just put a mirror here instead. So if I want, I can take this away. I can put a, let's see, decoration, wall hanging mirrors, and we can go with this. This is actually the same setup I used in my hair salon video. So if you guys haven't seen that yet, make sure to take the chance to watch that. I'll leave a link to that in the description below. But yeah, we have that. Maybe we want to add something like a nice carpet. Maybe we want to add like a red carpet, who knows? Or like a, not a carpet, but a, oh, that was a mistake. But like maybe some red draperies or something, I don't know. Could also maybe add something like some paintings or some kind of other furniture. Something I like to do is add like small tables in rooms like this because it gives kind of like a little bit of realism to it in the sense that it looks like someone uses this place. So for example, like the dressing tables, like we can put down a dressing table here and we can put down a chair. So maybe the servant chair looks like this. And that one actually works like this, which is why the storage thing drives me nuts that I can't do it with the jewelry, but it's okay. And then something else we could do is we can add some more candle sconces. So maybe we add, you know, some candles in here, and the room is already lighting up quite a bit. Something else we can do if we think that the room isn't as cool as it needs to be is we can actually change up the flooring. Maybe we want to do something a little bit more interesting, so we can maybe go with like a catacomb flooring or something like this. The catacomb flooring and the crypt flooring and stuff like that, that's exactly what you need for the servant coffins, so I recommend doing something like that, just so that your coffins, you know, cook fast enough. And yeah, so this is a nice little room setup. It's not too crazy. It's not like super like 200 IQ or anything like that. It's a very basic setup, but I think it's a really good start for anyone who's just kind of, you know, trying to figure out what the heck to do with their servants. So maybe if you have a bunch of servants and you want to have different rooms for them, maybe something like this could be a good option. And just to finish it up, we're gonna add some decorations here. We can add a clock. So we can add a clock right here. Make sure we don't lose track of time. Can't have those servants being late. We can also add something like a study table. So if you want, you can squeeze a little study table here right next to this. Or you can place it here. I don't know. It really depends on what you wanna do, because it's really like, what is the purpose of this room? You know, like I could have placed a study table here instead or here. So yeah, this is something to think about, and I hope that this one is a good example for some of you. And I just realized I forgot to add a painting, so we're gonna do that here. Done. All right, so for our next example, this will be example number 7. For example number 7, we're gonna make a bedroom. Of course, now that our servants have a place to sleep, we also need a place to sleep. And some might even argue that I should have made mine first, but yeah, that's besides the point. So I'm gonna make sure I set this up here. We're just gonna do a 4x4 again, and for this room, I'm going to use probably a nice wallpaper, maybe something like this. You know, maybe I want my room to be a little bit edgier, and it's sticking out in high contrast to the floor here, which I really like. So maybe we want to stick with that. We could also change up the walls. Even we can make the walls maybe like, I don't know, we could have maybe a couple of windows here in the bedroom. We could have a bunch of stuff, you know, but just in general, it's a nice thing to have. So I'm just going to add a couple of windows here. Maybe we want to change up with the draperies. So let's add some fancy wall ornament stuff. Maybe we want to go with like a black and white theme for this room. And of course, we need to redo the wallpaper now. There you go. And we can also make a couple of coffins here. So I'm gonna go with very simple design. We're gonna go with the stone coffins, and this stone coffin will be here with this one here, aligned well with the mirrors. Sorry, not the mirrors, the windows. And of course, this is a nice little thing to come out of. So if you have, I don't know, like a friend or someone who also sleeps in the same room as you, you know, you guys could be roommates, I guess. You could also maybe add something like a music box in here so that, you know, you can be lulled to sleep. I don't know. Maybe like, let's do that. You know, just to lull you to sleep, you can have like a music box in here. Maybe you might want to add, what I like to do is add like a nice carpet in here, because whenever the ground is as bright as that, you need some kind of carpet. So, yeah, we're going to go with that. Let's go with we could go with a round carpet. We could go with something, we could go with the whole floor being like, will it let us? No, it's not gonna let us. Okay, so the carpet's too big. Maybe we can try something else. Maybe we could try like a circle. Yeah, so because we have a square room and a circle in the center, the circle definitely creates a little bit of visual variety here, a little visual contrast when it comes to the shapes. So yeah, this is a nice simple bedroom setup, and of course you want to add some kind of lighting in here. So maybe we want to add something like some candle stands. So we could put some candle stands here, maybe like a elegant candelabra. I don't know if I'm even saying that right. I don't I'm not very good with languages, man. I gotta be honest, even English I'm struggling. But yeah, you can have like a little setup like this. You could have maybe some wall decorations. So maybe you want to do something like a let's go with maybe another lighting setup. You could maybe have like a light like right here in between if you want to be super cool and just have them like in the center. You could do that. That's another option. Or what you could do is you could put like a brazier here that's kind of, you know, just here, ready to go, ready to just look nice, really nice, amongst the coffins. And that's a really nice setup here. We could also maybe add some paintings. You know, there's a lot of things you can do in this room, but this is really simple. I think I've shown enough examples of like your walls getting decorated and things like that, but yeah, you can definitely set up something like this. If you were going to use the wooden coffins, though, the wooden coffins use up a lot less space. So if you really wanted to, you could probably place like several of these in the room and line them up. I'm not going to do that, but mostly because I just prefer this look. But yeah, that's something to think about. You can definitely do stuff in this room. So we're going to move on to the next example. All right, so example 8, we're going to make a jewel room. So of course I can't be doing these examples without some kind of practical knowledge here. And part of that practical knowledge does come with a purpose. So in this case, we're going to be making a jewelry room, and we're going to start off by getting the correct foundation. So I'm going to get like that's not the correct foundation. We're going to get maybe a refraction pattern. This is a new one. Haven't really messed with this too much. Let's get the crafting station set up. So we're going to put the artisan table here. We could probably fit the artisan table maybe like in this corner. We can also put the jewel crafting table all the way over here. And for the refinement, we can also get a gem cutting table. If not there, maybe there we go. Right here in the corner. Now, this is kind of a tight fit. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to rotate this over here, and then we're going to rotate this way. This is probably a little bit better. There we go. So yeah, you can get your gem cutting table all set up and everything. So it fits pretty well and pretty snugly against this, actually. But yeah, this little jewelry room, that is perfect for, you know, just squeezing things in. So, you know, even though the room is small, you can still do things with it. I'm just showing like how I like to fit up these that's not the word I wanted to use, but how I put up these crafting stations. I'm going to show you what I do with the storage too as well. So let's say I'm going to add maybe a small gem chest, gem storage. It doesn't fit here, but it does fit here. Or you can put like something like a large gem storage right here. You could also put something like a jewel storage, maybe not there, but like, you know, if you wanted to put a jewel storage instead, you could. But yeah, there's not a lot of space in here, so you're very limited in what you can do. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna move this over and I'm gonna check. I don't think this fits. No, it doesn't. So yeah, you can do that. You can put jewelry in here or something, but yeah, you have a few options as far as like what you can do. Next, we're going to go on to example number 9. This is going to be the workshop. So for the workshop, I like to put as many grinders in here as I possibly can. Mostly because that's the thing I use a lot, especially when I'm grinding flowers into pollen. Alright, so the first thing I want to do is change the foundation to be the appropriate kind. So we have three options. We have, you know, I'm gonna go with the newest option that they added to the game because I just like it. We're also going to add the different crafting stations. So, but first, I'm also gonna add the refinement stations. So I have options. I can either put maybe three of these small ones, or I can put two really big ones. So I think I'm gonna go with the two really big ones. Just for this example, because this is usually what people upgrade to by the end of the game. This goes to the crafting station, so maybe we need something like I missed the sawmill. We need maybe like a sawmill in here, so we can squeeze you know, a sawmill maybe like right here. We can also maybe add something like a I think that was it. It was sawmill. Oh, there is also the crafting table, the workshop bench, which, I mean, doesn't really fit in this room much. Like, if I wanted to fit the workshop bench, I could put it, in here. So, what you could do is you could have, actually, let me double check, yeah, so, you can maybe squeeze, you can't squeeze two of these, but you can squeeze maybe a workshop bench like right here into the corner, so you can fit like pretty much all you would need in here. I'm trying to think if there's anything else in the workshop that might make sense, and actually I think that's it for the workshop if I remember correctly. I'm sure there's something I'm forgetting and you guys are gonna point it out, so I'm sorry in advance, but yeah, this is all I can remember in the moment. So yeah, you can squeeze your little workshop here. This is usually what I set up, if I'm only in like a 4x4 space. So if you're like trying to, you know, be careful with the space you can, so you can maybe add like some storage. So, for storage in this kind of areas, you might want to put something like a material storage or like a, little material storage box or something. I personally don't necessarily like to use these material storage boxes all the time unless like I'm trying to, you know, be a little bit faster with what I'm doing, which is optional. But yeah, you can definitely add one of these in here. So now that is perfectly against this, and yeah, this is a nice little workshop area. And last but not least, oh, I did not mean to do that. Last but not least, we're going to put together the final build. I think this is the final build. Yeah, this is example 10. Oh my god. Wow, I can't believe we made it to the end of the video. I only had like 10 coughing fits. Anyway, so we're gonna make another room here. This room is going to be the tailoring room. So we're gonna start off. I'm gonna try and squeeze in as much as I can into this tailoring room. So I'm gonna start off with maybe like, actually let's start with a green carpet. Let's change it up. Green carpet, and maybe we got, for refinement, we have maybe a couple of looms. So we have the advanced loom, which eats up like a whole square or half a square, or we can get these, smaller looms, but of course the smaller looms can't do all the work, so I'm gonna have to put these in, right? And here's the hard part about this. So no matter what you do in this space, even if you have, you know, your tailoring bench, right? Your tailoring bench is always going to eat up a ton of space. So there's not much you can do to really negate that, but you can squeeze it into a room with a loom if you really want to. You could also maybe squeeze in, you know, a leather working station if you want. And you could also squeeze in maybe a small tannery or something like that. So just kind of giving you guys some ideas as far as the kinds of stuff you can do. So trying to find the tannery. Oh, here it is. So the tannery is huge, like the big one, right? But if you want a small tannery in here, you can't even fit that because there's no space. So this is something to think about. If you don't use the leather working station often, which is probably likely, my recommendation might be to just use another advanced loom here since you can squeeze it in. Granted, you're gonna be blocking the path a little bit, so you have to be kind of careful about that. Like, for example, like I can squeeze in the room here, but barely. So, you know, just kind of, you know, place these things at your own risk. if I wasn't going to be crazy like that, I could just place a storage container here like a normal person, and it would probably make a lot more sense. So we're gonna place that here. And yeah, I think that is probably good for this particular tutorial. Now that we've finished all the 10 examples, let's do a quick recap. So let's go to the beginning. Let's go back. Example one, we made a cozy fireplace with a sofa. All right, example two, we made an outdoor water fountain and sitting area. For example three, we've put together this outdoor picnic area, or a little outdoor dining area. For example four, we created a outdoor garden area that's more focused on the garden itself. For example number five, we created a closet or a changing room. For example number six, we created a servant's quarters. For example number seven, we created a bedroom. For example number eight, we made a jewel crafting room. A jeweler's room, I guess you could say. Example number nine, we made a workshop. And example number 10, we created a tailoring room. Now, maybe the last three weren't ones that you guys necessarily needed to see, but I just wanted to give an idea to maybe some of the newer players as to the kinds of things you can do in a 4x4 room in your castle. So yeah, no matter how small your rooms are or how big your rooms are, a lot of times planning is a huge part of how the castle ends up looking. So I wanted to make sure to make this video. So what do you guys think of these examples? Have you used any of them before? Do you plan to use any of these examples for your own castles? What other videos should I make? I read every comment, so make sure to let me know. In case you don't know, my name is Shiloh Q. I'm a Shiloh's Queenly, Reaper, and Guide to the Underworld. I stream three times a week on Twitch, Kick, and YouTube, and usually stream V-Rising on Thursdays. I post my schedule every Sunday on Twitter, my fandom Discord, and the YouTube community tab, so make sure to check it out. If you like this video, feel free to leave a like, share, and subscribe for more V-Rising content. I hope you have a wonderful day, and as always, Shiloh out.